Let me introduce you to ShareX, an open source software for screen capturing, image editing, file sharing, measuring, file conversion and so much more. ShareX has been in development for many years. It's free and has no ads. You can get it at getsharex.com. I'll try to quickly show you as many features as possible, but if you really want to take full advantage of its potential, you should explore the software yourself. I will be including timestamps for the video, so you can jump directly to features that interest you the most. Let's start with the screen capture options. ShareX can of course take simple screenshots. The classic full screen, just a specific window, or a specific monitor if you have multiple monitors. Region is the one I use the most because I usually only need a part of the screen. I set it up so my screenshots are automatically uploaded to an image sharing website and the URL is automatically copied to my clipboard. This makes sharing and linking screenshots extremely fast and easy. The other region options show less user interface if you need that. Screen recording obviously records a video of your screen. This requires the software FFmpeg, which ShareX will offer to automatically download. If that doesn't work, you can download FFmpeg from their website, ffmpeg.org, and copy the file to the folder ShareX tells you to. It records as MP4 by default, but you can change this in the settings. To record to a GIF file, use the second screen recording option. To screenshot scrollable windows like websites or local folders, use scrolling capture. I feel like this is an experimental feature because it doesn't always work for me. Text capture is amazing for creating editable text from images and other sources you can't just copy-paste. This also is rarely perfect, but saves a huge amount of time compared to manually describing long text. Lastly, auto capture can take a screenshot every few seconds. This is great for recording time-lapse progress, maybe if you're drawing something. Here you can also disable to show the cursor in screenshots and add a delay before taking the picture. The upload menu gives options to upload files, text to services like Pastebin, and a quick URL shortener. This is also very handy to upload several files directly from Windows Explorer. I'm gonna skip the workflow menu because this requires to set up custom workflows. They can combine several tools into one command. The color picker and the screen color picker are very useful for image editing. I use this all the time to sample colors into Photoshop. The image editor can edit screenshots directly after taking. It offers pretty much everything you would need for screenshots like cropping, adding text and arrows, highlighting and pixelating sensitive information. Image Effects has more advanced effects, but usually I don't need these for simple screenshots. HashCheck is usually used to compare hash values of downloaded files. Some websites post the expected hash value, which you then paste into the software. If these values match, the file was likely downloaded correctly. DNS Changer is for quickly changing the Windows DNS server for resolving domain names. I don't change it often, so I never had much use for it. QR code is much more useful. It creates QR codes from text and also decodes them. Very useful if you don't have a phone nearby or you don't want to blindly scan a potentially malicious one. The ruler is also handy for image editing. You can measure window sizes and distances on the screen in pixels. Directory Indexer gives you a quick overview of a selected directory. Image Combiner and Splitter do exactly that. They combine several images into one or split one image up. Image Thumbnailer creates a small preview version of an image. Maybe you need that. Video Converter is a simple video transcoder for quickly converting video formats. And Video Thumbnailer can create thumbnail images from video files. Then there is Tweet Message, a simple Twitter interface to quickly compose tweets. And finally, Monitor Test, to display several high contrast patterns to test your screen, for example to find dead pixels or other defects. Aside from the tools themselves, the program has the ability to create complex workflows we have seen above. There are lots of options and I don't think we have to go over every one. Just know there's a lot ShareX can automatically do after capturing the screen, even running batch scripts. Same thing with the after upload tasks. If you decide to upload a file, there are several automatic follow-up options. The destination settings are where you can set up your cloud or image hoster accounts. Pretty much any popular service is available, and even some self-hosted and traditional options like email and shared network folders. The settings allow you to adjust almost anything in the software, like image quality and file formats, file naming schemes, default folders, custom themes, and so much more. Here you can of course also change the hotkeys for your workflows. Last but not least, we have the options to open the screenshot folder and show a history of files created, screenshots taken, and links generated. That's it for the overview of ShareX. Explore it yourself and see if it's as useful to you as it is to me.